The story of Prophet Hud alayhi salam. A long time ago, in what is today Oman, there was a city called Irem. The ruins of the city lie buried somewhere in the sands of Rub al-Khali, or the empty quarter, an uninhabitable desert between Saudi Arabia and Oman. Irem was a very big city. The people who lived there were known as the people of Ad. Ad were physically very well built and known for their craftsmanship, especially in the construction of tall buildings with lofty towers. They were outstanding among the nations in power and wealth, which unfortunately made them arrogant. King Shaddad ruled over the 1,000 Adite tribes, each consisting of several thousands of men. It is said Shaddad defeated all of the Arabia and Iraq. The people of Ad did believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, they also believed in minor gods and practiced idol worship. They believed that the idols and the minor gods could help them in winning over Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to guide these people. So he sent one of the descendants of Nuh alayhi salam from among the people of Ad. The name of the prophet was Hud alayhi salam. Hud alayhi salam was from a tribe called Ad ibn Us, Ibn Sham, Ibn Nuh. Hud alayhi salam condemned idol worship and warned his people, "My people, what is the benefit of these stones that you carve with your own hands and worship? In reality, it's an insult to one's intellect. There is only one God, and that God is Allah. Worship Him alone. He created you, He provides for you, and He is the one who will cause you to die." The people of Ad, however, were extremely arrogant. They thought that Hud alayhi salam was trying to seek importance so that he can become their king. Hud alayhi salam told them that he sought no worldly rewards from guiding them. But they did not believe him. Instead, they told him, "O Hud, no evidence have you brought us, and we shall not leave our gods for your mere saying. And we are not believers in you. All that we can say is that some of our gods have seized you with madness." Hud alayhi salam tried to explain to his people that their actions in this life would be accounted for in an afterlife. But they mocked him and said, "Do you say that after we die and turn into dust, we will be resurrected?" The chiefs of the people of Ad said to his people, "As per the Quran, he is no more than a human being like you. He eats of that which you eat and drinks of what you drink. If you were to obey a human being like yourselves, then verily you indeed would be losers. Does he promise you that when you have died and have become dust and bones, you shall come out alive? Far, very far, is that which you are promised. There is nothing but our life of this world. We die and we live, and we are not going to be resurrected. He is only a man who has invented a lie against Allah, but we are not going to believe in him." The chiefs of Hud alayhi salam's people asked, "Is it not strange that Allah chooses one of us to reveal His message?" Hud alayhi salam replied, "What is strange in that? Allah wants to guide you to the right way of life. So He sent me to warn you. Nuh alayhi salam's flood and his story are not far away from you. So do not forget what happened. All the disbelievers were destroyed, no matter how strong they were. Who is going to destroy us, Hud? The chiefs asked. Allah, replied Hud alayhi salam. The disbelievers among his people answered, We will be saved by our gods. Hud alayhi salam clarified to them that the gods they worshipped would be the reason for their destruction, that it is Allah alone who saves people, and that no other power on earth can benefit or harm anyone. The conflict between Hud alayhi salam and his people continued. Years passed, and they became more arrogant and stubborn of their prophet's message. Eventually, Hud alayhi salam gave up guiding his people. He had no other way but to turn to Allah alone, and no other alternative but to give them a threatening ultimatum. He declared to them, I call Allah to witness and bear you witness that I am free from that which you ascribe as partners in worship with him. So plot against me, all of you, and give me no respite. I put my trust in Allah, my Lord, and your Lord. There is not a single thing on earth which is not within Allah's control. Verily, my Lord is on the straight path. So if you turn away, still I have conveyed the message with which I was sent to you. My Lord will make other people succeed you, and you will not harm him. Hud alayhi salam and his people waited for Allah's promise. A drought spread throughout the land, for the sky no longer sent its rain. The sun scorched the desert sand, looking like a disk of fire which settled on people's head. Hud alayhi salam, people hastened to him asking, What is that drought, Hud? Hud alayhi salam answered, Allah is angry with you. If you believe in him and repent, then he will accept your repentance, and the rain will fall, and you will become even stronger than you are. They mocked him and became more stubborn and sarcastic in their belief. The drought increased, the trees turned yellow, and the plants died. A day came when they found the sky full of clouds. Hud alayhi salam's people were glad as they came out of their tents crying, A cloud which will give us rain. The weather changed suddenly from burning dry and hot to stinging cold, with wind that shook everything. Trees, plants, tents, men and women. The wind increased day after day and night after night. Hud alayhi salam's people started to flee. They ran to their tents to hide, but the winds became stronger, ripping their tents from their stakes. They hid under cloth covers, but the gale became stronger and tore away the covers. It slashed clothing and skin. It penetrated everything in its way. The storm raged for 8 days and 7 nights. Everything touched by the wind was destroyed. Only Hud alayhi salam and his followers remained unharmed. They migrated to Hadramaut and lived there in peace, worshipping Allah, their true Lord. Hud al-Islam was buried there, a land where he led believers with faith. The lesson of the story is that one should remain humble, even if one becomes successful. One should give all the credit for one's achievement to the blessings of Allah. In not doing so, one's success could be ruined in the same way as the great homes of the people of Aad were destroyed by the great storm sent by Allah.